नमस्कार, वेलकम टू टुडेज कॉन्सेप्ट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली। टुडे द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन डिटेल व्हाट इज अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली। व्हाट इज अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली, द स्टूडेंट्स हैव टू राइट दिस डेफिनेशन। द ड्राफ्टिंग ऑफ अ डॉक्यूमेंट कॉल्ड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वॉज डन बाय द असेंबली ऑफ इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स कॉल्ड the constituent assembly. So what is a constituent assembly? A group of elected leaders given a task of completing a document called constitution, which will be the whole and sole Solomon authority to decide who will make the laws, how the election process should happen, how the election voting process should happen, who will form the government, how the government should be formed, what kind of government has to be formed. Like this, all details are mentioned in the document. That document is called the rule book. The rule book is called the constitution. So what is a constituent assembly? The leaders, the elected leaders, who are given the responsibility to draft a document which is known as the rule book of the country, the constitution, is called the constituent assembly. In simple words, an assembly of elected leaders whose task is to complete a detailed document about the country's future, known as the rule book of the nation, constitution. So what is a constituent assembly? We discussed till now. The constituent assembly is very, very important and plays a very major role in determining the future of the country. So the elections to the Constituent Assembly were held in July 1946. The elections of the Constituent Assembly were held in July 1946. So the first meeting was held in December 1946. There was an issue that time, as I told you in previous sessions, that India and Pakistan were partitioned. So India was going through a great turmoil, a pain, where Indians were divided on the name of religion. So the first meeting held in December 1946, the country was divided into India and Pakistan. Similarly, the Constituent Assembly was also divided into the Constituent Assembly of India and Constituent Assembly of Pakistan. Naturally, when the country is divided, obviously the task and the assemblies also will be divided. And the Constituent Assembly that wrote the Indian Constitution had 299 members, and they have worked tirelessly for roughly 3 years, exactly 2 years, 11 months, 18 days. After they worked for 3 years of continuous debates, suggestions, amendments, finally, the constitution was adopted on 26th of November 1949 and decided that it will be coming into effect on 26th of January 1950. Now, if you remember, 26th of November is nowadays observed as Constitutional Day since Narendra Modi has taken the charge of the power. He declared that 26th November will be observed as Constitutional Day in India. So that day in 1949, it has been adopted, and 26th January 1950 onwards, it came into effect. This marks the day we celebrate as Republic Day every year, because the Constitution came into force from 26th of January 1950. From 1950, 26th of Jan is celebrated as the Republic Day of India. Now we all might get doubt. Does the Constitution reflect the views of its members alone, or did it have the views of all the people at that time? Because if you remember carefully, Mahatma Gandhiji was not member of Constituent Assembly. But most of the ideology has been taken from his disciples or followers from the Congress party, because they were the members of the Constituent Assembly. Mahatma Gandhi has already decided how the constitution of an India has to be there when it becomes independent. In 1931 itself, when he wrote in Young India magazine, he gave his ideas. So people all have an idea of what Gandhiji's views are. So they adopted all the views of great leaders, and they also took a broad consensus of its time. During 1947 to 1949, there was a huge debate, discussions happening. The entire Constituent Assembly met only for debating in 112 occasions spread over 3 years to discuss on the draft bills, to take the suggestions, to review them. And if you print them, if you print the Constituent Assembly debates, it will become 12 bulky volumes of printed books. That much explicitly in detail they have discussed, and they have come to a common conclusion. Today, we can say that our constitution is very, very successful. We should salute to our Constituent Assembly makers, starting from Baba Saheb Ambedkar to all the 298 other members who were the members of the Constituent Assembly that day, who had a great vision and stood and rose above the occasion. Though they all have their painful hearts, India and Pakistan being partitioned, 10 lakh people passed away on either side, till they stood to the occasion and they planned for the great future of India. Why I am able to tell proudly that we have made a wonderful constitution, the best constitution which we have currently. Many countries in the world have had to rewrite their constitution. In our neighborhood, we have seen in Nepal where they are rewriting the constitution. Some countries have changed their basic rules because they were not acceptable to all after some time. The Russia's constitution has been changed. USSR got disintegrated. But major social groups and political parties in India never ever opposed the entire constitution. There might be questions about few sections, few articles of the constitution, but not against the entire constitution. In some other countries, there are constitutions existing only on a piece of paper, but no one actually follows them. In that cases, our constitution has lived up during the time of emergency, and it has been stood up during the time of crisis. India has seen many wars, been victorious. Even at that time, never a military coup happened in India. In India, the constitution is supreme. Whether we like it, we don't like it, we have to accept it. And every section of people are being given the rights in our constitution. So we proudly can tell that our constitution is one of the greatest constitutions in the world at that point of time when they were written. And there are amendments done to keep it as a living document. That's all we have in today's video. We learned about what is a Constituent Assembly. Then we looked at how the Constituent Assembly was formed, how the partition happened, when it came into effect, why we observe Republic Day, what is the greatness of our constitution. So hope you all understood this one. Thank you.